taught you that you could have whatever you dream. Well, I want you to hold on to that dream, baby. Hold on to it real tight, because the sky's the limit.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How's everybody doing tonight?
All right.
I'd like to welcome to the stage the lyrically acclaimed.
Woo.
I like this young man. Because when he came out with the phrase, he went from ashy to classy.
All right.
I like that.
All right.
So everybody in the house, give a warm round of applause for the Notorious B.I.G. The Notorious B.I.G., ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for him, y'all. A nigga never been as broke as me. I like that. When I was young, I had 2 pair of leaves. Besides that, the pinstripes and the gray. The one I wore on Mondays and Wednesdays. While niggas flirt, I'm throwing tigers on my shirt and alligators. You wanna see the inside? I see you later. Here come the drama. Oh, that's that nigga with the fake. Wow! Why you punch me in my face? Stay in your place. Play your position. Here come my intuition. Go in this nigga pocket. Rob him while his friends watch it. That hoes clock it. Here comes respect. This crew's your crew, or they might be next. Look at they man, big man, they never try. So we roll with them, stole with them. I mean loyalty, niggas bought me milks at lunch. The milks with chocolate, the cookies, butter crunch. 88, Oshkosh and blue and white dust. Ask the
sky is the limit, and you know that you keep on. Just keep on pressing on. Sky is the limit.
Of them, long as I got stuff for most of them soft. Even when I was wrong, I got my point across. They depicted me the boss. Of course, my orange box cut to make the world go round. Plus some fucking bitches ain't my homegirls now. Start stacking, dabbled in crack, gun packing. Nicknamed Medina, made the scene, took my Nina. From gym class to in glass, passed off for global. The only nigga with a mobile. Can't you see like total? Getting larger and wasted and taste. Ain't no telling where this felon is heading. Just in case, keep a shell at the tip of your melon. Clear the space. Your brain was a terrible thing to waste. 88 on gates, snatching issue nameplates. Smoking splits with niggas. Real life, beginner killers. Praying God forgive us for being sinners. Help us out.
Sky is the limit, and you know that you keep on. Just keep on pressing on. Sky is the limit, and you know that you can have what you want. Be what you want. Sky is the limit, and you know that you keep on. Just keep on.
In a second, Mama. Leo.
Well, I tell you, that boy is sometimes as fast as he's on the court, you think he'd be faster out of the house.
Look at him. Let Brad have the ball. I'm coming down on him, one on one. 5 seconds left in the game. Oh, you can't guard me. Think left, right, who's that? Hey, wow, what a shot, 2 for Brad.
Cornbread's gonna drive me crazy. Come on, Charlie, it's time to get up.
What time is it?
It's early, it's real early.
Hey, the time is right, Mama.
Mm-mm, not for Cornbread pounding away up there.
I want to do some pounding myself.
Charlie, come on.
What's the matter?
Come on, man. Get your butt up and get upstairs.
Why? Because of Cornbread?
Shh, no. I said Wilford. That noise is going to wake him up, too.
So what?
Look, I don't want him coming in here finding us like this.
You think he don't know?
He don't know for sure.
12 years old. Huh? 12 years old, living in this place he don't understand.
Are you gonna come to the meeting tonight, Sam?
You ought to go for that stuff, honey.
Oh, Sam, it's our neighborhood.
You take care of the Urban League, the NAACP, and the Baptist Ladies Garden Club. And I'll take care of the tester, my wire cutters, and my weekly paycheck.
Hey, I work too, you know.
And I wouldn't have your job for nothing in the world. But I thank you for it. But leave me out of the other stuff. I ain't no joiner.
Get out of here.
Listen,
Sam Hamilton, a grown man like you playing the same game every morning. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Stop. Good, Pop.
Stop. Now give me that. Give me
fingers.
Give me that ball.
Good move, Pop. Good move, Pop. Good move, Mama. You should set a good pitch.
Yeah, Leona, we're going to get you a scholarship, too.
He fouled me. Did you see him foul me? Now, wait a minute. This is a dining room, not a gym, so you check that outside.
Oh, Mama.
Don't you owe Mama me. That's not food. It's too tough to eat, so it stays outside.
What? Mama, I love you, but you're wrong. This is food and more. It's food and clothes for you and Pop and a house as big as a barn. Hey, Pop. Come on, Mama.
Come on, boy.
See this thing, Mama? Come on, Mama, look at it. Because it's going to take us off the street. Ain't that right, Pop?
Right.
It's going to buy us a house where the kitchen is as big as this whole building on a street with trees and grass. And it's going to buy a freezer, Mama, bigger than me, filled with all kinds of food.
Right. And you are going to keep that ball right in the bottom of the freezer, right?
Right. Get out of trouble. Hey, wait up, Pop. I'll come with you.
Hey, wait a minute. Now, you're not going to have any breakfast?
No, I'm not hungry.
Well, you can't live on orange soda.
Go, man, go!
2 weeks, huh?
Look out. Yeah.
The school's a long way from here.
College. You want me to be in college.
Yeah. Just gonna miss you.
You ain't kidding me, Pop. You gonna be able to sleep if I ain't bouncing the ball. Cut left. You and Mama come to the school sometimes to watch me play?
Better know it. Wouldn't miss it for anything.
Go, man, go. Morning, neighbor.
As long as you got one hand on that ball, I guess you're safe.
Hey, superstar!
What's happening, one eye?
Woo! When you gonna start running numbers for me?
What are you up to?
Hey, I'm selling dreams, Sam. There'll be pie in the sky when you buy from one eye.
Yeah, just lay off my son.
Hey, he can make a ton of money running numbers for me, Sam.
I'll tell you what, Pop. As soon as I get out of college, we'll have him put it in my pro contract. Cornbread runs for one eye in the off season.
John, you look like you got a hangover.
A hangover? There are three kids sick. I'm up all night flushing the toilet, and you told me about having a hangover.
What, you got stomach flu?
I don't know, maybe. Maybe it was that recipe that your wife gave to my Mary Tuesday night, too.
I will admit, John, that barbecue sauce is pretty hot.
Hot? Hey, we put some in the freezer, huh?
Yeah.
Freezer defrosted.
Oh.
Yeah. Hey. Isn't that an old pal Shifty over there?
Yeah. The last time we saw him pushing something, it was heroin. 10 to 1, John, there's no baby in that carriage.
Oh. Hey, hold it, kid! Nice seeing you again, Shifty. You can put your hands down now.
No, I feel safer this way.
You know, somehow you just don't look natural unless your hands are into something. Put them down, slow and easy.
What are you dudes always hassling me?
This is just a social call. We want to meet the family.
Man, this is my sister's.
I lost him, John.
That's all right. Shifty wants us to meet his family. Can we take a peek at the little darling, huh?
Oh, that's a cute kid, Shifty.
Where'd you get the typewriter?
Man, I told you it was my sister's. I'm just bringing
it
to be fixed.
You know the route, baby. Hands on the car, spread your legs. Attaboy.
Hey, Nathaniel. Hey, Nathaniel, pick a card. Come on.
Oh, Mr. J, I gotta go play ball.
Oh, come on, just take a minute. Just take a minute.
Okay, okay.
All right, take a look at it. Remember it?
Got it.
Put it back.
Hurry up, Mr. J, they're waiting on me.
All right, I'm hurrying. How's your mom and dad?
Oh, they're just fine.
All right.
Now it's that one, six of diamonds.
Right. Hey, how'd you know that?
I guess that wins me another orange.
Keep the change, Mr. J.
Hey, you owe me.
Cornbread wants a root beer, and he bought one for us, too.
He don't drink root beer.
What? I've been watching him, man. He drinks orange and grape and once in a while Coke, but never no root beer.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I know lots of things you don't know, man.
You don't know nothing.
Oh, I don't blow your little sack. Look here now. Let me show you
this. Oh, Mr. Fred, don't stop.
Come on, pick a card.
We'll take just Cornbread his drink. Yeah.
All right, pick a card. Pick a card. Come on. Take a look at it. You gonna remember it?
Sure, the two of spades.
You ain't supposed to tell me.
Were you asking?
Oh, never mind. Give me the money.
Orange! Root beer! Orange! Root beer! Orange!
Now,
root beer! Root beer! Root beer!
Now, shut up. Where would you be if I wasn't here to settle your argument? Wait right there.
Okay, Earl. You pick a card.
Five of diamonds.
You aren't supposed to tell me.
All right, wise guys, all right. You like orange? You both like root beer, all right?
Yeah.
All right, you bring these to Cornbread. Whichever he chooses,
You split the other.
Okay, Mama's Fred. Mama's Fred.
Hi, boy.
Off to college in 2 weeks, huh, Leon?
Honey, I'm gonna miss that boy. It's gonna be so lonely without him.
Yeah, even the balance of basketball at 5 a.m. in the morning?
Yeah, I know what you're saying, Sarah. It won't be long, though, before it'll be Wilford. That child is certainly growing up, isn't he?
You know, he really admires you, Nathaniel.
Yeah.
Anything your son tries, my son is bound to copy, even with
the best. Is this your son?
Yes.
I'm Al Patterson, the manager, and I found him with this.
Mom, you said I could have it over there, remember? Some candy?
I don't understand.
Mr. What's Patterson, up? I was just ringing it up with the rest of Mrs. Robinson's stuff.
Okay.
Old 15-cent candy bar.
Well, but it doesn't matter whether it's 15 cents or $1 million. It's stealing.
Don't cry no more, Mama. I won't do it again. I promise I'll never do it again.
It's okay, Wilford. You're a good boy. I know. You're a real good boy.
Time like this. Wilford, you go in and wash up.
Well, Sarah, how have you been?
Hi. Miss Parsons, I didn't expect you here today. I would have tied it up a little bit.
Well, don't worry about that. But there is a reason why I made a special trip over here, because there is something I want to find out. Why haven't we had your regular medical report?
I'll tell you why. Because you didn't take the time to bother to go down to the clinic for your regular medical checkup. Look, Sarah, you and I both know that the only reason that the department sends you those checks each and every month is because of your supposed heart condition.
Yes, I understand that.
And if it wasn't for that heart condition, we wouldn't even consider paying the state's money to a healthy girl like you. You understand? You do understand?
Yes, I do. See, if I could hold a job, I really would.
The minute that they find out that there's any nonsense in your medical report, you can be quite certain that your checks are gonna stop.
Well, I'll go down to the clinic.
Good. Well, that settles that. Everything else okay?
Yeah.
How is little Wilford?
He's fine.
He's not getting into any trouble, is he?
No. Wilford.
Well, I know how difficult it is raising a child without a father. But it's your duty to keep little Wilford from evil companions.
Evil companion.
Oh, I still can't believe she said that.
She did. Evil companion.
They find that welfare lady.
Down there with the evil companion.
See you later.
All right, please. Night
now. Good night.
You're cool. Good to see you.
Night, Mama. You sure you're feeling all right, huh?
Yeah, I feel fine. My heart feels much better now.
You don't have no business dancing anyway.
What do you expect me to do, sit back there and twiddle my thumbs while you carry on with Edna?
What was I supposed to do? She just dragged me on the floor.
I didn't see you putting up any fight.
Hey, hey. Hey, hey. Oh, oh, oh. Wait a minute. I was only jiving.
Maybe... Man, you know me better than that.
Yeah, maybe you were jiving, but I ain't too sure about Edna.
Are you jealous?
Maybe.
Well, maybe if we moved in together,
you could keep a closer eye on me.
John, you talking about getting married again?
Nope. Talking about moving in.
Welfare would love that.
All right, I'm talking about getting married.
Well, then who's gonna pay the rent?
Well, who do you think I will? I mean, I can't find a better job. It's not like I ain't been trying.
I know you've been trying, Charlie.
Yeah, but it ain't good enough for you. What you're saying is I ain't good enough for you, right?
Come on now, Charlie. You're getting so heavy.
Well, sure. This is a heavy time.
Feel it sometimes. It's like the whole city is just sitting on your shoulders. Hey, but you got the light touch. Your fingers.
What they doing here?
Watching TV.
Hi, boy.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mrs. Robinson.
What are they doing here?
You know I don't like Wilfred here alone when I'm out late. So I asked Earl to spend the night with him.
Come on, now get him out of here.
Must be joking.
But I ain't joking. This was supposed to be our night.
Now, Charlie, cool it. Now, don't spoil it. I had a fine evening. It's the best I've had in a long time.
Come on.
Let's go get some cook.
No. You stay there. I'll go get
some. No, let him stay there. Are we going to use the bedroom anyway?
No, we ain't.
Oh, well, then let him go in the bedroom. We'll use the sofa. Huh? Oh, come on, Sarah. What is it?
Not tonight, Charlie. I'm not in the mood for TV.
Television? Oh, Mom, what is wrong with you? Are you sick?
Charlie, I think it's getting a little late for everyone.
Are you throwing me out?
I ain't throwing you nowhere. You live upstairs.
Oh, come on, Mom.
Charlie!
Why don't you make up your mind, huh? My name is Charlie this, is Charlie that, Charlie go, Charlie stay. What do you want me to do? Just shake your hand and smile and go upstairs and spend the night all by myself in that rotten bed?
Hey, wait a minute.
Well, you got another thing coming. You gotta keep it out on your fingers. See, like this. Okay, now you try it.
Like that, Homer?
Yeah, that's better. Okay, it's me and you, one-on-one. Keep your back to me and guard the ball with your body. And your right hand out so I don't get it.
I can't get it, Cornbread, not like that.
Oh, yes, you can, Will.
Can I shoot?
Sure. Okay, you face the basket, you be in balance. You get the ball, you put it on your fingertips.
Okay.
And make sure it feels good, and
right.
Take your time. Okay, it's on your fingertips.
and you hold it high and let it fly. Listen, I'll see you in the locker room in a few minutes.
Come on, Will, get going.
Mr. Wilson's gonna be here any minute. I think you guys better split.
The hell with Mr. Wilson. What did you do with them pills, man?
What pills, stud?
Come on, man. You know what we're talking about. The stuff that was in the locker.
I flushed it down the toilet.
What? Hey, man, that dope was worth a lot of bread.
I told your friends not to bring that stuff in here.
Nah, you don't tell us nothing, superstar.
Man, your time has come.
Look, I ain't got time for this.
Kid was telling me in some kind of trouble.
My cousin.
Well, what kind of trouble?
It's all over, Mr. Wilson. Thank you.
We sure don't want anything to happen to you, Nathaniel.
Ain't nothing going to happen to me, Mr. Wilson. That college needs me too bad.
2A36.
2A36.
Ambulance gunshot victim, 5525 West Elm. See them in.
To A36, Roger.
Hey, that's back in this block.
Come on, kids, buy your pop.
Guy comes busting out of there carrying a gun. Almost knocks me down. Then he turns and runs up them stairs. And I wasn't about to follow him.
Describe him to me.
Hank, too dark out here.
Was he black?
Of course he was. Wasn't that dark out here.
Anything else?
Yeah. He was big. Mighty big.
She's shot and she's hurt pretty bad, too. But she's breathing.
I'm going after him.
Okay. I'll wait for the ambulance and then I'll follow you.
Hey, John, heads up out there, man, all right?
Hey, this ain't no playground. Cash customers only. Come on, son, go home.
Come on, Pop, it's raining outside.
Yeah, I know it is, son. That's good for it. Wash some of that schoolyard dust off you. Now, come on, move out. I mean it. Man. I ain't running no free store.
Come on, boys. Let's go home. Come on, son. Those threads.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All courtesy of that great big policy wheel spinning up there in the sky.
Your pie must be soaking wet today, One-Eye.
You passing up a good thing, Cornbread. Running for me will pay you more than running up and down on a wooden floor.
Wait a minute, One-Eye. Lay off him. He's leaving for college in 2 weeks. He's the first boy from this neighborhood to make something out of himself.
Hold on there.
I mean something legal.
If the good Lord didn't believe in numbers, he would not have invented the wheel.
Whoa!
Nathaniel. You must live on that stuff.
Hard to believe orange soda can make a kid grow 8 feet tall.
Thanks, Cornbread.
Yeah, thanks.
I better get on home.
Oh, it's raining too hard, son.
And you'll drown out there.
He's so quick he can run between the raindrops.
He's the quickest there is.
Oh, yeah.
He is. Ain't you the quickest, Cornbread?
Quick enough.
I bet you could make it home from here in about 10 seconds flat.
Aw.
No, not that fast, little cousin. Maybe in this rain, I can make it in 25 seconds.
No way. You'll never do it.
I bet he could.
I bet he could.
What you got to bet, little man?
Bet him a bottle of pop.
Is that a deal?
That's a deal. Okay, Mr. J, one more orange for when I get home.
How are we gonna time you, Cornbread?
Look, I got the watch.
No. Nothing on you runs straight. We'll use mine.
Jesus, Larry! You see him? Where the hell did he go?
Listen, John, be careful. He's some kind of a nut, you know what I mean? Okay, everybody outside.
Get off that!
Thank you! He's dead!
that's your son. I'm sorry. But is that Nathaniel Hamilton? Sign here, please.
We have him now.
Street ain't never been this clean before.
You think they can wipe out Cornbread that easily?
Mama, I don't think I'll play basketball as long as I live.
She will, too. Not today. Someday soon.
They murdered him, Mama. They killed him.
They're not gonna kill you.
Who's gonna stop him?
You and me. Cornbread didn't make it, but we're gonna work real hard. We're gonna get you out of here.
I'm afraid I still don't understand precisely what it is you expect of me.
The police killed our boy.
Yes, I know. Can't nothing be done about that. But according to the newspapers, he assaulted a woman and very nearly killed her.
It's a lie. My son ain't commit no crime.
Well, then why did he run from the police?
He wasn't running from the police. He was at the candy store drinking a soda. He was running home in the rain. And they shot him in the back.
And he had nothing to do with the crime?
Nothing.
Well, they say the victim is unable to identify her assailant.
Well, I wish she could, Mr. Blackwell. Because if she could, she would tell you it was not our son.
Well, then you want me to bring an action against the city for wrongful death. Well, you see, if the police shot and killed your son without just cause, you can sue the city and collect damages.
We don't want money.
We want our son's name cleared. We don't want nobody going around saying that our son was a criminal.
We want the police to admit that they did something wrong.
I'm afraid you won't get them to admit anything. You have to prove it in a courtroom.
Then we go to court.
Perhaps you ought to think this over for a few days. First, there'll be an inquest. Then you file your civil suit. The procedures will be expensive and very difficult. Excuse me. Yes? Tell him I'll call back. And hold all calls, please. Thank you. I'm sorry for the interruption. The city has received a lot of bad publicity in this matter. You can expect the district attorney, the coroner, and the police department to close ranks and try to protect each other. You'll have to find witnesses.
We got witnesses.
You'd be surprised how strangely people behave when they have to testify in a legal matter. There'll be pressure brought to bear in a lot of places. What's this?
That's a plane ticket.
afraid I don't understand.
Mr. Blackwell, our son was a fine athlete. A lot of colleges offered him scholarships, and he had finally decided which school he wanted to go to. This morning, we were supposed to drive him to the airport so he could fly down to school. That's his plane ticket. We'll cash it in and bring you the money as part of your fee.
Mrs. Hamilton, you don't have to do that.
That's the way we want it, Mr. Blackwell.
My goodness, you can see the whole world from up here. Come on now, Wolford. You can't see nothing staring at your lap.
Ain't nothing I want to see.
Hey, look over there. That must be our street, Wolford. Wolford, won't you at least look?
Okay, I'm looking.
You shouldn't be here, Ben.
Look, I know that. But I told the Hamiltons that you and I grew up next door to each other.
By the time I was 10 years old, you were way...
But I was sure you were a straight cop. Are you still planning to be a teacher?
Yeah. 6 years of night school. I should get my credential in January, then we'll see what happens. I mean, I'm not a lawyer, Ben, but I do the best I can.
I admire you for sticking with it.
What do you want, Ben?
I'm hoping you can tell me something about the Hamilton case.
We filed a complete report with the division. Right? And then they in turn send copies to Homicide, the DA's office, and Internal Affairs, which I'm sure you've read. Now, as long as Golderton and I testify to what's in that report, exactly what's in that report, we got no problems. The city will back us 100%. Now, we changed one word, Ben, and we got troubles. And you know that, man, so don't... I don't know what you're talking about.
There must be more to this thing than what's in that report.
Well, you're talking to the wrong guy. Talk to Golich. He's all uptight about this mess.
But not you.
No, not me. I know we shot the right guy.
How come Golich doesn't know it?
Well, he knows it. But those newspapers, you know, they kind of confuse them. I mean, you got headlines like mistaken identity and good family, good kid, police brutality. You've heard it all before, Ben.
Officer Golich has a conscience.
Oh, well, he can afford one. He's white.
White, black, green, red. Look. I wonder if you know all about the kid.
You mean that he was an athlete, right? Big-time hero, right? Good guy. Had a scholarship. Everybody's darling. Shit, Ben, he just never got caught before.
What if I told you I have witnesses? Now, I'm not drawing any conclusions. Witnesses who told me that Cornbread couldn't have committed any crime. But they actually saw him drinking a bottle of pop in a grocery store at the time.
So that means I'm lying, right?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, Larry. I'm sure you did what you thought was right. Maybe I'd have done the same thing.
Oh, would you, Ben? Would you? You and your Brooks brother's lawyer's suit?
Now, wait a minute. Where did you think I got this? In law school, 14 years old. Right in front of the house on the street where you lived.
Well, it looks like to me you healed up real well, Ben.
but I am still on those same funky streets day after day, trying to deal with the maniacs, man. And let me tell you something. Those cats are after me with more than just a safety razor.
Now, don't give me that poor cop on the beat, big city lawyer shit.
Well, then don't give me that old buddy from the neighborhood crap, man. This is me, Ben. This is Larry. Now, you could not wait to get your black ass out of that neighborhood. Don't jive me, man.
You know, I'm beginning to understand. You spent 6 years getting ready to educate the natives. And now they turn around and clobber the great missionary.
No, they're not natives, Ben. They're savages. And I am the keeper of the savages. And I keep them all together. So they'll chop each other up and not maybe go into your neighborhood, Ben, and chop up the good people.
For a guy who's only done his duty, you're mighty worked up. Now, you listen to me. You ever stop to think why those people beat you on the head? Because they've seen cops gun down people before and never made a move. Why this time? Why?
Because Cornbread was a good kid. And because they know he never did anything to earn a bullet in the heart.
You talk about teaching. Are you going to tell those kids they're nothing but savages?
No, Ben, you'll tell them. Because people like you tell them that every day of their lives.
If that's how you feel, a decent, honest guy like yourself, what chance have they got?
The same chance everybody's got.
And I am tired, Ben. So just get out. I'll be damned.
I don't know why, but I always liked the Ferris wheel the best.
You know, Mama, I keep talking about Cornbread, and you keep talking about something else. Now, we're going to have to talk about Cornbread sooner or later.
That's all we've been doing for days now, thinking about Cornbread, talking about Cornbread. But it ain't doing us no good. No matter what we do, we can't bring him back.
Cornbread could have hit 50 straight.
What about the looper? We're going there?
Nah. I come to the carnival once with Cornbread. He didn't like the looper.
Cornbread's not here. You and I are.
Yeah, I know. Cornbread ain't here. Tell me why. Mama, can we go home now?
Why don't we go on the cyclone? I like that ride. Come on.
This ain't good for you, Mama.
Sure it is. It keeps me young.
Mama, you sure look weird.
You don't look so hot yourself.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Simmons and Kelly, downtown.
Downtown? Usually see the fellas from the station out here.
We hear you've been doing a lot of talking to a lot of people, huh?
Oh, you mean about the Hamilton kid, the one they shot?
You understand Blackwell wants you for a witness, right?
Sure, why not? I saw those cops gun down that kid.
You saw it, huh? That's strange. How could you see it when you were so busy?
Busy? Man, I wasn't busy.
Why don't you give us a couple of bottles of soda, huh?
Sure. On the house. Let's see now. What kind?
Marijuana.
I hear all you colored store owners keep a supply for the school kids.
Well, when the judge gets hold of the guy that's doing this, whew. Was that you were saying about the shooting?
Hey, man, I just thought maybe you guys... No, it's just like he said. I was back here working. I was busy. I don't know nothing. Just like I said, all the time. I knew all the time that kid was no wrongdoer. I don't know nothing. Honest, I don't know nothing.
I'll just keep these for you for a while.
We might see you again, huh?
Hey, man, how you gonna see me again? You ain't even seen me the first time yet. You dirty bastards! You redneck sons of bitches! Goddamn dirty rot!
Mr. Johnson?
Yes, yeah, son?
Why don't y'all want me to tell the truth?
It's not that we don't want you to tell the truth. We just don't want you to say anything right now. That's not telling a lie, is it?
Yes, it is.
What did you say?
Well, Mama says that if you see something wrong, and you don't say nothing about it, well, that's just the same as telling a lie. Right, Mama? And I don't tell no lies, do I, Mama?
All right. Now, I've been trying to be easy with you folks. Now, I'm the precinct captain, and behind me is a whole damn city. Now, if you want to take on a whole city, you go right ahead. Sergeant Danaher is waiting to question Wilford, and he'd better get the right answers. You hear me? He'd better get the right answers. Because if he doesn't, you can forget about your welfare check.
You wouldn't do that.
Oh, I'm finally getting through to you, huh? You just remember that, Sarah Robinson. You let this smart-ass kid of yours talk too much, and you'll be off welfare. Like that.
Okay, kid. Now, what do you know about this thing?
Nathaniel Hamilton. Cornbread. Whatever you people call him.
What do I know, sir?
Yeah, did you see him the day he was shot?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean you saw him? That ain't the right answer.
Well, I saw him.
Jesus, what's the matter with you people? Didn't you listen to what Johnson said? All right, well, don't let that kid give me any trouble.
We don't want any trouble.
Okay, kid. Let's take it from the beginning. As far as I get it, you don't know nothing at all about this whole thing.
He didn't say that.
I'm talking to him. You don't know nothing, right? You didn't see nothing. Did you?
Take your hands off him.
You didn't see nothing at all, did you?
Take your hands off him.
Shut up.
I will not shut up.
I said shut up, goddammit. Any more of this crap, I'm gonna run both of you in. Come back here!
Johnny! Johnny, there's a man beating my mama! I'm scared, Johnny!
Where are you?
Hurry up!
Listen, you can answer me, see? Oh, goddammit, I got...
Hold on! What's wrong with you?
You better
put that away before you get yourself in trouble.
You better have this kid alone or you're going to be in trouble. Now get over there, move.
I'm a police officer.
Charlie, that man beat up my mama.
Sarah! Sarah, the bloody Sarah! Bloody! Sarah! You dirty mother! Charlie, you got to get out of here.
They'll be back, Charlie. They're gonna beat you bad.
Yeah, yeah, listen, she's right, man. Here, take this, hide it somewhere anyway, okay? Listen, boy. You see how you're messing up everybody's life? You see how much trouble you're causing? Well, if they hurt your mama, I'm gonna come back here and kick your tail in.
I appreciate that, Mr. Blackwell. He said he'd do what he can.
What does he understand about that policeman hitting Sarah and Wilford?
Of course.
Where is Wilford? Oh, he was just here a little while ago.
I probably just went out to play.
Play? He wouldn't play at a time like this, man. Run away.
Oh, no.
No, no, no. Wilford is a smart child. He wouldn't do a thing like that. Now, you know that.
He's run away.
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, come here. No, come on. No. Oh, Sarah, you're sad. I know, I was putting too much pressure on him. He's only 12 years old.
You're getting yourself all upset over nothing, Sarah.
That's right.
What if that policeman finds him? He'll beat that child.
Ain't no policeman, not even a white one, want to beat a 12-year-old boy.
Yeah, but he heard what Charlie said. He thinks he's making trouble for me. That's why he runs away. I know him. I know.
Take it easy, honey.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. Now, everything's going to be fine.
You're the Robinson boy, Wilford?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's the card I gave your mother. And I suppose the guys in the garage told you where my car was. Yeah, you don't miss a thing, do you?
No, sir.
Hamilton called. He told me what happened to you and your mother. I'm heading for the police station to try and straighten it out. Hold it now. Now, hold it. Close the door. Now, just relax. The cops aren't going to make any trouble for you while I'm around. Okay? Your mama didn't send you to me. So she doesn't know where you are. We better go call her.
I want to talk to you first.
Okay, we'll sit right here and talk.
Well, you see, I'm the one that started the whole trouble. Because if I hadn't told Mr. Hamilton that I seen them shoot Cornbread, then he wouldn't have gone to you.
You did the right thing.
Yeah, but now they're going to take off the welfare. Policeman comes and beats up on me and Mama. And then Charlie says that I'm the one that's causing all the trouble and splits.
So what's the answer, Wilford?
I'm gonna run away. Then I don't have to lie, And they can't take Mama off the welfare. See?
Yeah, I see, but you run away and your Mama's gonna be plenty worried.
Yeah, that's where you come in.
Me?
Yeah, you find me a safe place to hide.
Well, then I'd be lying instead of you. And I know you wouldn't want to make me into a liar.
I still can't understand where you found him.
Oh, he came to me. Wilford came to my office to see how he could help the situation.
I really can't thank you enough.
No trouble. It's all settled now. I couldn't tell you over the phone, but I made a deal with the police. They won't prosecute you and Charlie, and we won't press charges against Sergeant Danner.
You're something else, Mr. Blackwell.
Wilford gave the police a statement while we were there. I'm sure they won't bother you again.
I'm so very grateful. Come on, Wilford. You gotta go get your pajamas.
Okay, Mom.
Put your pajamas on.
There's no reason Charlie can't come home now.
Charlie doesn't live here. He lives upstairs.
Oh.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
No, thanks. It's been a hard day. But maybe we can do it another time.
I'll hold you to that, Mr. Blackwell.
Mrs. Robinson.
Sarah.
You have an extraordinary son. I have to think you're a very special kind of woman. Say goodnight to Wilford for me.
You like Mr. Blackwell, Mom, don't you? I like him too.
You was ready to run away, weren't you?
Yes, Mama.
You thought by doing that you would make my life easier? Wilfred, there is nothing in my life more important to me than you. Ain't nobody gonna scare us away. We ain't got much, but we do have our self-respect, and now they're trying to take that away. They figure because I'm on the welfare, they can get me to keep you quiet. But I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna ask you to do what you think is right, whatever that is. Do you understand me?
I think so, Mama.
All right. This inquest will please come to order. This is a hearing concerning the death of one Nathaniel Hamilton. Let's have a member of the family step forward and check out the family history.
The boy's age at the time of his death.
18.
And the boy's means of livelihood?
Student.
Well, you mean he's unemployed.
Mr. Coroner, the young man worked part-time at a recreation center, but he was enrolled in college and due to begin classes within 2 weeks.
The boy was not in school at the time, counsel, therefore he was unemployed.
Well, with all due respect, the fact remains that Nathaniel Hamilton had graduated from high school and was about to begin college.
All right, counsel. Well, I don't suppose there's anything else that we need to know. That's all. There's a $27 inquest fee, but if you sign this waiver, you'll have to pay it.
Do you mean to tell me they're gonna make her pay for them killing her son?
Next, they're gonna ask her to pay the cops for their bullets.
You really don't have to pay it, you know.
That's right, Mrs. Hamilton. Why don't you sign the waiver?
This isn't my idea, you know. But the legislature won't abolish the fee. That's all. Thank you, Mrs. Hamilton. You can go back to your seat now. I'm sorry. Very sorry.
Thank you.
Our people made a very thorough investigation. In the first place, our informants tell us Nathaniel Hamilton was a member of a gang that robbed a number of people and was guilty of many acts of violence.
Sergeant, just describe the incident.
Yes, sir. Officers Gulich and Atkins answered a call and found the victim unconscious from a gunshot wound. Officer Gulich followed the assailant up on a roof and down the fire escape. Officer Gulich called out that he was a policeman, but the suspect continued down the fire escape. Then Atkins and Gulich together followed him through a building and out into the areaway. They again told him to stop, but he did not. They didn't shoot because they could not see him clearly. Then he ran into the street.
Go on.
The officers followed him. He had a shiny object in his hand, which they thought to be a gun. The officers then ran out into the street so they could avoid shooting innocent people.
Continue.
The officers gave a last warning, and when the suspect didn't stop, they shot and killed him.
Thank you, officer. Counsel, you got any questions?
With your indulgence. You told us that in chasing the suspect, the officers lost sight of him on one or more occasions.
Yeah, but just briefly.
Briefly. But they did lose sight of him. So the person they shot may not have been the person they were chasing.
Well, this guy was running and they told him to halt.
What about the garbage truck?
What garbage truck?
Wasn't there a garbage truck on the street, and wasn't it making so much noise that no one could possibly have heard the officers, even if they did, as you say, tell anyone to halt?
I don't know nothing about a garbage truck.
All right. The policemen are in the street, and they see someone running. Is that right?
Yes, sir. And they thought he had a gun.
The shiny object. What kind of a day was it, Sergeant?
Rain.
Light or heavy?
Pretty heavy.
And dark. It was dark, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And on this dark day with heavy rain, the officers saw a shiny object in the hands of someone running in the opposite direction. Is that your testimony? Officer, did you ever find the so-called weapon?
No.
Did anyone? Anyone tell you they definitely saw a weapon?
Well, the officer said they thought he had a gun.
Did any other witness tell you what Nathaniel Hamilton had in his hand at the time of the shooting?
Yeah. Little kid said he had a bottle of pop.
A pop bottle. Is that what he said?
That's right.
It was orange pop, wasn't it?
Which I don't remember the flavor.
Check your report.
Look, if you say it was orange pop, it was orange pop.
No, it's not what I say, it's what you say. You're under oath. You have the statement of the witness. Check it.
I don't have the statement.
Oh, come now. This is the most important witness. Surely you have his statement.
No, I just can't find it in the records.
Mr. Coroner, this is an offense that amounts to criminal negligence. What are they trying to hide?
Take it easy, counsel. If a statement's been lost, it's just been lost. The witness is here. He can tell his story anyway.
For all the good the investigating officer has done, I'm surprised he didn't lose himself. That's all. I don't want to waste the coroner's time with a liar.
Yes, sir. 13 years with the sanitation department.
13 years. Mr. Watkins, you testified that you were driving your truck on the day in question, and that you actually worked the street on which the incident took place. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Now then, did you see the shooting?
No, sir.
Wait a minute. We know the policemen ran into the street and fired their guns right in front of you. Are you trying to tell me you didn't see them?
Well, I just wasn't looking out.
What were you doing?
As a matter of fact, I was reading my daily report.
Your daily report?
My daily report.
You were so conscientious that you studied this report and kept studying it while all hell was breaking loose around you?
I didn't see nothing.
What did you hear?
Nothing. The garbage machine was making so much noise, I couldn't hear anything.
Well, that helps.
It does?
Okay, Mr. Watkins, you didn't see anything and you didn't hear anything. And if I'm the judge by what's gone on before, you aren't going to say anything.
That's right.
You watch, Mr. Fred. You just watch him, huh? Watch him tell him.
Now, Mr. Jenkins, will you tell us in your own words what you know of this occurrence?
I don't know nothing.
Oh, Mr. Fred. Earl, you hear that? That's wrong, Mr. Fred.
Shh. So you didn't see this?
No, I didn't see it. How could I? I was busy working in my store.
Was the Hamilton boy in your store before the shooting?
No. He wasn't in my store. Wasn't nobody in my store.
Great. How can you say that?
Lying out there.
That's right, Mr. Fred. You're lying.
You're lying. Fred, you're sitting up there and you're lying.
Just a minute.
What did they do to you, Fred? They beat you up? 20 years we've been friends, and now you do this to me.
You sit down, or I'm gonna have you removed from this room.
I never hurt you, Fred. Cornbread never hurt you. You just trusted and believed in
me. Marshal, remove that man.
Me, Leon, and Cornbread. We've always done what's right. So then they go and kill my boy for drinking a bottle of soda and running down the street. That's what they killed him for.
Sam, I know you're upset, but Mr. Longhouse. Let's not get excited here.
You tell me not to get excited? You killed my boy! You in hell! What did he do that you up and shoot him so fast?
Oh, Mr. Hamilton,
would you have shot him if he was white?
I'm talking to you!
Sam!
I'll take him out of here.
Hold it!
Please!
was his son, Mr. Corbin. I think he ought to be allowed to stay.
Sergeant Danaher, who's your next witness?
I guess that would be the boy, Earl Carter.
Judge, Your Honor, this here is my boy, Earl, and I brought him here today.
You sit down.
But, Mr. Judge, Judge, Your Honor...
One more word, and I'll have you thrown out. Now, I don't want to hear any more outbreaks from anybody.
I think that should be pretty clear. All right, boy, come on up here.
Now, son, before I swear you in, do you go to school? Do you know the difference between telling the truth and a lie?
Come on, Earl, man. Come on, don't be afraid.
Can't you talk?
Just a minute, Mr. Coroner. You're frightening the boy. Maybe if you didn't shout at him...
Now, counsel, if he's telling us the truth, he hasn't got anything to be afraid of. But if he is lying to us, then he ought to be frightened. Now, are you going to answer me or not?
Just come on, Earl. Say something.
Judge, Your Honor, when he was a real little boy and he got scared, he used to do the same thing.
I thought I told you to sit down.
But that's my son, and he don't know nothing. There's no need in asking him, because he ain't going to say nothing. I told the police. He don't know nothing about nothing.
Well, why didn't you say so? Sergeant, did you get a statement from this boy?
No, sir. He wouldn't say a single word.
I'm not surprised. You probably tried to shake his brains loose.
Mr. Coroner, the counsel is insulting me and the whole police department.
All right. All right! I'm sick of these arguments.
Counsel, I don't know where you find your witnesses, but this is the third one we've had up here who doesn't know anything about this case.
Mr. Coroner, these witnesses were intimidated. If they were allowed to testify freely, they would have told you that Nathaniel Hamilton was at that grocery store. It's the same old story, Mr. Coroner. The administration cover-up.
Counsel, don't make charges you can't prove.
Mr. Coroner, we don't think this shooting was done maliciously. We believe it was an accident. A case of mistaken identity. But the police won't have it that way. I don't know why they're afraid of the truth.
I wish you would stick to the facts.
You did see them shoot Cornbread, didn't you? Didn't you? Never mind, Mr. Coroner. I don't want to hurt this child any more than he's been hurt already.
They've got no case.
Well, Wilfred Robinson, please come forward.
They got to him, too.
Wilfred Robinson?
Wolf, yes, Mama? You want to do what's right, and I want you to. I want you to be a man. So you be a man right now. And from now on, no matter what happens, you'll be a man for the rest of your natural life.
Wilfred Robinson? Well, is he here or not?
Now, did you know this boy, Nathaniel Hamilton?
Yes, sir. I knew Cornbread all my life, ever since I was a real little guy.
Right, on the date in question, did you see this occurrence?
Yes, sir.
Where were you?
In front of the store.
Which store?
Mr. Fred's store.
All right, Wilford. Now, you go ahead in your own words and you tell us what you know. But you start at the beginning and tell us everything you know.
Well, it all started when me and Earl was watching Cornbread and the other big guys play basketball. Then it started to rain. And then we all ran down to Mr. Fred's store. Mr. Fred, he was mad at having all those kids in his store. So he began to yell in. Pretty soon it was just Cornbread, me, and Earl. And then Cornbread brought us each a pop. And, you know, he was always good to us. Then he bought one for himself. And then One Eye came in.
Beg your pardon, did you say One Eye?
Yes, sir, everybody out there knows One Eye.
I see. Go on, son.
No. Then Cornbread said that he had to get moving. So he bought another pop for himself to drink at home. And then we said that he ought to wait until it stopped raining. But he said no, that he had to get on home. And then me and Earl, we got to arguing. We's always arguing as to how fast Cornbread could run home. And I said, maybe 10 seconds. And Cornbread laughed and said, no, about 45 seconds. And then we made sort of a bet. Then me and Earl and Mr. Fred and One Eye went out under the awning with Cornbread. Cornbread took off with his basketball under one arm and his orange pop in the other hand. Boy, you should have seen how he ran. Cornbread ran. Didn't even look like he was moving. He could sure run. And boy, was he moving. And then me and Earl, he gets to counting. While Cornbread's running, you know, and a one, and a two. And Cornbread's pumping away, and it's raining, and Cornbread's racing down the block. And then those two cops, they run into the street. And it looks like they yelled something. But I couldn't tell what it was, because there was that garbage truck grinding away. Anyhow, those two guys, they had out their guns, and they shoot. And they shoot Cornbread. Then he was dead. They killed Cornbread and he wasn't doing nothing. All he was doing was he was just going home.
I don't know who's lying. But somebody is.
Kid's gotta be lying.
Counsel, do you have any questions?
Just one. Wilford.
Hmm?
Do you know anything about Cornbread belonging to a gang?
No, sir. He didn't belong to no gang. Didn't have to. Besides, he was always playing basketball. Sometimes at night, when it was quiet, I could hear the bamming and bamming of that basketball right up against that backboard. And I knew it was Cornbread, because it couldn't be nobody else. Yep, and that bam, bam, bam will put me right to sleep.
No, sir. He ain't belong in no gangs. Not Cornbread.
It took a lot of courage for you to come here this afternoon. I'm proud of you, son. Thank you.
Officers Golich and Atkins.
Yes, sir?
You were both there and you're both fired at the deceased. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, one of you can testify for the two of you. Officer Atkins, let's have you up here.
Late, and I don't want to waste any more time. Now, you heard the testimony of the investigating officer.
Yes, sir, I did.
Do you concur with his testimony?
Well, sir,
Officer, I'm waiting for an answer.
Larry.
Don't. Rotten bastards, won't they get it over with?
You see, sir, what we wrote in that report is correct. We were pursuing the suspect, and we did utilize standard police procedures.
Officer, you're trying my patience. There's no need to repeat to me what's already in the report.
Yes, sir, I understand that. I have been listening to the testimony here today, especially the testimony of that little boy. And I have to say that I think he's telling the truth.
Just a minute, Atkins.
Officer, you realize what you're saying?
Yes, sir, I do. I realize that what I'm saying is that if that kid is telling the truth, and I think that he is, then God forgive us, because we must have shot the wrong man.
There must be some mistake, Mr. Coroner. This officer has signed a statement. We have it on file in our records.
I've heard enough. This hearing is closed.
Thank you. It was a privilege to represent you.
You aren't going to believe that crap, are you, Mr. Coroner?
You've had it, Sergeant. The next person they're going to be investigating is you.
Some baskets with me.
You mean you ain't mad?
Heck no, I
I ain't mad. After all, we blood brothers, ain't we? Yeah. Here, take a shot. No, Earl. That's not the way. Let me show you what Cornbread show me.
Okay. Okay, now. Cornbread says that you gotta hold the ball on your fingertips.
Yeah.
Nice and light. When you know you got the touch, you got the feel, you let it fly.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it, Earl. Great, fantastic. You got it, you got it.
Come on, come on. I see no changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a Negro. Pull a trigger, kill a nigga, he's a hero. Get it back to the kids, who the hell cares? One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship them, don't let them deal with brothers. Give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead. I got love for my brother, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how it's supposed to be. How can the devil take a brother if he's close to me? I let it go back to when we played as kids, but then it changed. That's the way it is. Come on, come on.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah. Just the way it is. Things will never be the same.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's just the way it is. Oh, yeah.
I see no changes. All I see is racist faces. Misplaced hate makes disgrace to races. We under. I wonder what it takes to make this one better place. Let's erase the wasted. Take the evil out the people, they'll be acting right. It's both black and white, and smoke a crack tonight. And the only time we chill is when we kill each other. It takes skill to be real, time to heal each other. And although it seems evident, we ain't ready to see a black president. It ain't a secret, don't conceal the fact. The penitentiary's packed, and it's filled with blacks. But some things will never change. Try to show another way, but staying in the dope game. Now tell me what's a mother to do. Being real, don't appeal to the brother in you. You gotta operate the easy way.
I made a G today.
But you made it in a sleazy way. Sell a crack to the kid.
I gotta get paid.
It's a long way from the ghetto to the number one spot on the musical charts, but Sparkle, Sister, and Dolores had to start someplace. It's the 1950s, and there's a new sound in music.
Friends of mine are having a party tonight. Thought you'd like to come by so we could share your success.
Your eyes within me, they send me just for staring me down.
Soon the group was on its way to the big time.
I'm so turned on in time, it shall I got to move around.
Let me see
it. Give me that! Give it to me! God!
Come here!
Do you see? Sister can't fly on one wing.
Living in a world of ghetto life. Everyone is so uptight, but nothing's wrong
I got to sing about? Sex, what have I got to sing about?
What happened to sister, not to you. You got your whole life.
So if you look into your heart
with a positive mind,
with a positive mind,
take self-inventory, you woman and your glory.
Bad things behind.
Put them behind.
Yeah.
I know my man.
The next stop, Carnegie Hall.
Loving you, baby, brings the chills right down the spine.
You give me so much joy.
That Curtis Mayfield sound is back. Five new sensational songs from another spectacular Curtis Mayfield score. Some of it was singing. A lot of it was loving. Most of it was living that brought success to Sparkle.